activity completion and H5P. You all know that the activity completion must be enabled per activity, or we can say the resource, whatever content that we add on the page. And also we have to make sure that activity completion is turned on at course level. But how do we know whether this is turned on or not? You have to go to course settings from the actions menu on the right top of the course, and then go down under completion tracking. You will see enable completion tracking is marked to yes. That means completion tracking is enabled, and you will see these tiny boxes on the right for each item on the course, whether it is activity or resource, depending upon the kind of activity and the conditions you specify, these boxes appear. Okay, whether to make Moodle mark automatically or user can mark it manually. So let's see how this activity completion settings we can set under H5P activity. This is one H5P activity. Let's go to the settings under activity completion. So completion tracking, you have three options. You know that we can choose not to indicate activity completion, or student can mark manually, or activity is complete when conditions are met. So there are two conditions, required view and required grade. Require grade means student must receive a grade. Here, everybody will get this doubt while working with H5P, that in H5P, the feedback comes immediately, it will show the grades. But then even if the user gets a zero, that's also considered as grade, right? So somebody raised this question, and under Moodle Tracker, they are working on this. I hope it will be fixed pretty soon. Anyway, for H5P activity also, under grades, we can specify the points that user must receive, and also grade to pass, we can specify. When we mention that grade to pass, under activity completion, if at all that option is there, that grade student must have a passing grade, then it really works pretty well, right? Okay, these are the activity completion settings we can do for H5P under the activity settings in a course page. Okay, one more beautiful option that we have is, as a teacher, we can see activity completion report. How do we access that? Again, go to your actions menu of the course and click on more and see the reports. Under reports, you have activity completion, and this is the report. All activities, whether they completed or not, it will be shown. You can download this report also. If at all you are using the latest version of Moodle, that is 3.11, this activity completion settings differ a little. We will see, like here, there are no tiny boxes on the right, but the option is, the condition is explicitly given here, view to complete it, right? Or if it is manually marked, then mark as done. That is, option is given to student, right? So, but then how do we set that? Again, go to your edit settings of the course. Under completion tracking, you have extra option called show activity completion conditions. So yes and no. If you say yes explicitly, it will explain. If you say no, it won't show on the course page. But whenever user access that particular content, either a resource or an activity, on top of that each activity type or a resource type, they will see, users will see these activity completion conditions, right? So this is how in the latest version, this activity completion tracking can be marked. Similarly, activity completion report also got some new features. We will see that. Let's go to course and let's access our reports. Okay, let's click on more. Under reports, we have activity completion report here. And what are the new features is, we can choose which activity to be shown in this report, or we can decide activity order also, whether how it displays in the course page or alphabetically also, we can choose. Activity order can also be chosen. This is the latest version option. So this is about activity completion and H5P. And in latest version 2, I explained. So I hope you practice well.